Emmanuel.
Hello and welcome to Lyotrade Freeze Dryers, where my colleague and I began producing affordable freeze dryers for food. These machines are designed for small businesses and entrepreneurs. Freeze drying or lyophilization works by freezing the material, then reducing the pressure and adding heat to allow the frozen water in the material to change directly to a vapor. The food remains fresh and has a longer expiration date. It's also lighter and it can be usually rehydrated. The idea to start our own freeze dryer production came from my colleague and co-founder of the company, Pavel Johan, who thought that if we could not find a global manufacturer of these small freeze dryers, we would start making them ourselves. By that time, we had about 15 years of experience in supplying laboratory instruments for freeze drying. The difference between a food and laboratory freeze dryer is in the price to capacity ratio. A lab device has a rather small capacity, but a high price. A food device does not have to be so precise, and is, therefore, significantly cheaper. We currently use a original Prusa i3 Mark III, which we upgraded to the S version. This was our first 3D printer. We have had it for about 4 years, and we recently acquired the Azteq Industrial from Trilab, which also falls under Prusa Research. We use 3D printers to print prototypes needed for quick testing. That means we need them within hours to know how a particular part will look like. And of course, today we use 3D printers for the production of mass-produced devices. I estimate that currently about 10 to 15% of the parts on the entire device are 3D printed. We mostly use materials like copolyester, PLA, and recently we have been incorporating more industrial materials, like polycarbonate or fluorodur. We primarily use industrial materials for printing parts where we need significantly higher durability, especially against temperature, but also against ozone, oils and various chemicals. We need to be sure that the parts will not start to soften even at 100 degrees Celsius. With the Azteq, we were able to print very large pieces of ABS, polycarbonate, and often we do not have to use a brim. So that's something the MK3S was struggling with. We couldn't create such an environment to print from these materials reliably. Right now, 3D printing for us means freedom, as we are not dependent on suppliers. One thing is to request a product where we first have to spend considerable costs on a prototype, and only then the mass production can proceed with some reasonable expenses. We can manufacture the part ourselves and we can adjust it anytime, which is quite common with us. And in the future, we plan to involve more and more industrial materials in 3D printing, which could sometimes help us replace things like metal and industrial plastics. I will certainly be pleased if 3D printing continues to develop in the direction Prusa is taking – simplification and removing obstacles. After all, we only got into 3D printing in 2018, and I was surprised that people were raving about a flexible plate and how easy it was to remove the parts from it. So I found out that back then it was normal when parts were being peeled off from glass. So if it continues developing step by step like this, it will benefit everyone.